I think fundamentally, you only find out the quality of the foundation of anyone or anything years down the line, once the pressure begins to build, whether it's a structure or your very individual personal foundations. So ensuring that they're built on the rock, a faith, Jesus-based, and whatever that outworks as, basis, is really, really important. Just as it would be in a building that's 100 years old, or 200 years even, in the case of the building that we're about to see.
Can you tell us why you bought Henbury House and what brought you to be here 22 years ago?
We bought it originally, my brother and I, as a business project, and I thought we would take 15 months to get the planning permission sorted out and we'd make 150 grand and move on. But that wasn't God's plan. But when we came, there were cracks everywhere, and there'd been cracks everywhere for best part of 200 years. The solution had been fill the crack and decorate and end of crack. But of course, you get another crack somewhere else. It doesn't actually resolve anything fundamentally. So we had to involve English Heritage, and all sorts of people came and told us what they thought. And we measured and found that from the front door to the back corner is 6.5 inches out, which is fairly catastrophic. And we had to dig out everything we're standing on down 6 feet deep. And when we started in this room here, the gravel was so hard, the guy said, we can't dig this up. Why are you digging up what we dream of building on? This is perfect foundations. Why do you do it? And I said, because somewhere hidden between there and the back wall is the condition that is causing the cracks that everybody's been papering over for 200 odd years. And if we're going to resolve it, we've got to get in and sort out the foundation, and then eventually there won't be any more cracks. What I learnt here, amongst many other lessons, was that actually as we resolved the foundational issues, the cracks got significantly worse. We had cracks this wide running along 20 foot, Mark seen them.
I've slept in those rooms.
Interestingly, the people that are looking at the wrong thing will say, when you're actually resolving the fundamental problem, you're making it worse. And the answer is no, we're actually resolving something that's been a condition here for 250 years. This business of being built on rock is just crucial, whether it's the family, the house, the business. If it isn't Christ-centered, then cracks are inevitable and you can patch all you like, but it's a waste of time.
Yeah.
But sorting out foundations, as you know, breaks your back, breaks your tools, breaks your heart, yes. Breaks your bank balance.
Yes, you feel really
sometimes. And people say, well, what have you got to show for it? And the answer is, well, it's all hidden.
I think that anybody that embraces these principles and becomes connected in a dynamic way with God, whatever their business, will benefit. What may happen, though, in the process is that they realise, actually, this business is like this. It needs to change to be more like that. And so it's kind of a spiritual management consultancy almost going on with God and others to bring you into a position where you can be blessed.